people coming late?
I can start.
I can start?
Yeah, it's actually really tight.
Okay, it's recording, so we now start. Hello, everybody. This is my daughter, Ming, which I would like to introduce in this talk, besides other things. And, well, I noticed that in this year's DevConf there were a lot of kind of history talks. And I turned 50 2 months ago. Maybe this is one reason to make some history. My grandson turned 2 years, 2 days ago. And I want to talk about two women now, which mean a lot to me. So, but first, I would like to introduce myself. Who am I? And who is my wife? And then I want to give some good reasons or some reasons why my wife could be jealous about Debian. And if it's about jealousy in marriage, usually you have children involved, and so how did I got the daughter thanks to Debian? Well, this is actually the woman I met more than 30 years ago, and I decided to spend my life with her, and I never regretted it. And I would like to explain what you can do to make your family also not regret to meet you. You geeks are a little bit strange. And this strangeness, for instance, started in my case with this. Please raise your arms. Who knows this? Okay. Who doesn't know it? Who has never raised his arm? Who's not awake? Ah, okay. Take some coffee, and then we continue. So, punching cards, this was, well, about half a year. I touched the computer with punching cards. You don't really touch it, but it occupies, well, the morning when you prepare a job and the evening when you get the results. So I cut it from the day before work and after work. Okay. This was the first thing my wife had to be very tolerant. The next thing, I was doing some practice in some, I never touched this kind of computer, it's kind of PDP-11. But on one day my wife intended to cook for me. She was at home at the spare day and I forgot. I just forgot all the computer. So can you imagine? But anyway, she decided to marry me. And I'm really happy about this. So, and yeah. Then later, I got my son. I have only one real son. And my wife said she was pregnant with her son, and I was pregnant with our first PC computer, right? So he has this PC computer. It's a little bit later now, he's entertaining this. And he also got kind of a hacker later. So, now my relation to Debian started. I was seeking for some kind of Linux distribution. And, well, you know, we all started with Slackware or so and something. But then I needed to install a computer which was very weak and which had only this capacity to mount via NFS. And it was not, the installer didn't support this. And so Susan G. Kleinman, I never met this woman, but somehow my start in Debian is involved with this woman. She compiled 3 times the kernel just for me, sent it by email, and I installed with this kernel, and finally I managed. So, and so I decided, well, if somebody is that engaged and is caring for me that much, that must be the right distribution. And this was somehow my engagement with Debian. And, well, what was a marriage? I started to contribute. And usually in Debian, contribution means you fix something which is missing, and in this case it was missing that the package WordNet, maybe somebody knows, this is a monolingual dictionary, was not maintained anymore and was in danger to be dropped. It was at this time, in 1998, the case that it would be dropped. And so I decided to become the maintainer, but it was a little bit complex for me. And so I started with something simple, and this is Xteddy. Who knows Xteddy? It's just a cute pad you move around on the desktop, and I wanted to make it more attractive for my son, and I added some extra. This is one of the pads of my son and the penguin, so it's free software, you can add something. So I started packaging what my colleagues might need. You know me from the Debian Mail, but this is not the topic of the talk today. And I think in a partnership, two sides complete each other. Debian really provides a lot, and I decided just to contribute my small share. The wedding was in 1998. It was a confirmation that I got a Debian developer account. I had never expected that I later would stand here in front of the audience of the Debian conference, so I was just happy that I would upload rights for two or three packages, but it just became more. And then, well, the honeymoon was somehow at Debian Conference Zero. Formally, I met only one Debian developer. I had not even a cross key checking or so. It was not necessary at this time. I met on holidays when Luther in Strasbourg. This was so first holiday with my wife in France, and we met somebody. But as I said, I met the real crew of Debian developers at DevCon Zero in Bordeaux, and I had several or countless other events. I would like to make a small report about it, so you know. DevConf is one event which is very special, and I met lots of other conferences which my wife liked more because she, at least in parts, was together with me. But first, please give a big applause to my wife because she always tolerates what I'm doing. Thank you for this. So, yes, this was not DevConf Zero, but DevConf One. I see at least one face from this picture here in the room. Yours and me, and there are several others here at DevConf. We were really young. So, this was some other fun. Thomas Lange is also here at DevConf. Yes. And then there was another event which moved me a lot, that was showing me that Debian is really family. You see this t-shirt about morons. I'm surrounded by morons. It looks offensive, but I'm wearing it if it's a little bit touching, because the first Debian developer who died was Joel Eastby-Klecker. He died at the age of 21, so, and nobody was aware that he was really ill, and basically Debian was his life. He was coding from the bed, he was not able to move, he was just doing all the things in his life for Debian. And I think 6 weeks before he died, he just wrote an email, "Sorry guys, I can't do my work anymore." This was a very saddening moment, because nobody was aware of this. And this touched me a lot. Okay, so but back to the nice things. After DevConf 3 in Oslo, we did some holiday. We liked it. So this was the only DevConf my family was joining me, but not actually joining. I was on the DevConf. They did day trips, and we enjoyed Norway afterwards. This was the Open Source World Conference in Malaga. Also a nice event. I know some people. Martin Michelmeier and Jordi Malach are also here on the conference. And yes, Bide for sure. Bide is always on the conference. Yeah? That is, I don't mention this. And this was a mini DevConf in Beijing. I was the first time in Asia. And the interesting thing in this DevConf was, you see there's also a Microsoft conference there, but we have the way larger advertising. You know, it's three times as large. I also met some people here who also attended this conference. Yeah, now the nice things, the Libre Software meeting, this is also a nice meeting in France, but not more relaxed than their conference. So my wife enjoyed this. This is in Amiens, really nice city. And when I say I'm married with Debian people, I go also with the beach with all these people. This was in Argentina, Mar del Plata, what they call winter. It's not really winter in Mar del Plata, but it's actually Argentina winter. And please look at the guy with the kilt going in winter time in Argentina to the beach with a kilt and bathing. This was kind of an event, right? We had a lot of fun. At least three people of this picture are here. And again, I went to Malaga to some open source world conference, also a nice event, and afterwards I spent my wife in Spain. Very nice, she liked it a lot. And I give this hint to you. If you want to accept your partner that you are moving around, just try to show the world a bit. This was a LibreSoftware meeting in Nantes. You see this small hacker guy is grown up meanwhile. And this was a DevConf with Cazares. I was stealing the DPL spear from the bottle of the pool. It was fun. I do not really drink beer, but this was fun. And I was invited to DudeConf in 2010 in La Coruña, and we did some holiday before in Santiago de Compostela, Galicia. Very nice, we liked it a lot. And we were also invited to MiniDevConf in Paris. You see, Debian is also traveling the world, right? I was on lots of places of the world, and these are the nice ones. Yeah, now I come to the most favorite DevConf of my life. This is DevConf 2010 in New York. Thanks to the video team for recording everything. This is DevConf 2012 in Managua. Again, thanks to the video team for recording it. And this is DevConf 14 from the external hack lab. I'm using the scenic hack lab sign from DevConf 13 because it's my home is a scenic lab, hack lab, right? I just like it. And finally, DevConf Cape Town. This was the most favorite DevConf for my wife because we are watching in an extended family now. So there's a very interested potential viewer attendee of further DevConfs. Yes, and now you see I'm grandfather, and for some joke, before I turned grandfather, we started the Potential Grandfathers Project, right? Potential Grandfathers means you have a child that could have a child, because we were not grandfathers at this time, and well, it probably was some cheese and wine party, you know Christian Perrier, and so we had some fun, and I advertised this as an April Fool's joke. And this shows also some kind of misunderstandings that can happen with Debian, because Bob Hilliard, it actually was somebody I was connected with my first package, and I appreciated him, and I was very sad because he's actually a grandfather, and he took this joke serious and was really not happy. So this was a little bit saddening to me. Even his son is Debian developer, so we had a grandfather, father, couple inside Debian. And there was another misunderstanding. I was pointed out that we should not exclude grandmothers. Yes, that's true. I now know that we even have potential grandmothers in Debian. I'm not sure if we have real grandmothers, but potential grandmothers. So you see, Debian is fun and miscommunication, as in any normal partnership, right? So then I turned real grandfather. It was the day before I went to DevConf 15, and I interrupted the DevCamp for one day to take this photo. And now we come to the point where I met the very nice lady who became later my daughter. Min, do you want to say something now? Can you hear me?
I'm not really good at like expressing my thought, but how to say? very happy that I got one more pa. Yeah. So my like father in Vietnamese, and
yeah,
it's not hard for me to say.
Ba means father in Vietnamese, right? I'm her ba. And we met her in some kind of city partnership meeting and exchanged emails. So far, nothing happened. But then we had to mourn another loss in Debian because QT Sidal, some people might know her because the name sounded familiar to me because she was translating like crazy. Everything was not able to escape was translated by her. No real sense to translate very specific things. And she also died, and this announcement, I said, well, it would be nice if a Vietnamese woman, which was very active, would be translated into Vietnamese. And so my idea was, hey, there was this kind lady, maybe she would like to translate. And I asked me for a translation, and 4 hours later I got an email, sorry for the sad story, please find the attached for the Vietnamese translation, and I'm happy that I can help you with something. Good night. And so I think this is the mail I like. It was kind, it was precise, it was helpful. This, I liked it a lot. And maybe Min likes to talk something about how she received this email from me, because she is not a computer expert. Yeah, I mean, what's your memory of this?
Before answering your question, that I say that my husband usually call me Dory. But there are something in my life that is really hard to forget, and I never want to forget. But it's kind of unforgettable memory that the very first time that I met Andreas and Katrin. But at that time, I didn't know that later they become my adopted parents. And that's kind of, I consider it's kind of magic in my life. And it's for a really nice talking with them at the first met. And we still kept in touch, and then I remember that I was sitting in my office, got email from Andreas, me for help translation of that view of Vietnamese contributor, it's not Vietnamese, but the contributor. And at that time, I felt I had no reason to refuse such a nice friend. At that time, I considered Andreas is a very nice person and my friend. But I don't know how a friend turned to be a father later.
Yeah, it's always, you never know how it develops. But at this point in time, I also would not have known how it might develop. And, well, the next step was somehow that means started to translate more, because I explained a bit, and then finally she became proud enough to go to DevConf. Also Paul Weiss forced her to, or suggested her to go, and so you also need to know she is not an IT person at all. She has no idea what a GPG key might mean, you see, just working at the city government of our twin town, and that's all. And it took some time to get her to Germany, and I need to thank the DevConf Weiser team, the DevConf Bursary team, also the government of my hometown, Wernigerode, because they wrote also some letters to convince the government of Hoi An to let Min go. Huong, who is a person who is running a really nice restaurant in Wernigerode, is quite famous in the city and around, and she did all the things with the partnership and our first travel, but without her, this talk would not happen today, right? And also thanks to Min Endurance, and finally my spare time I had doing because I need to recover from some knee surgery. And finally, Min arrived in Heidelberg. I think a couple of people were in Heidelberg. Min, do you want to say something to, how you felt in Heidelberg?
Yeah, but before I, like, it's my flash about Heidelberg.com 15 that I want to say something like, it's how I get to know Debian first. When you send me an email that asks about the translation of the news, then before I got that email, I didn't know what is Debian. Actually, I have no idea about that. Some project on Debian exists. And when I translated news and I searched on the internet something about Debian, and that the very first time that I knew Debian. And from time to time, I get more information about Debian, and then when you ask me that if I want to join to be a contributor, and then it kind of I never imagined that I can I could go abroad to Germany to Europe, and but you asked me to apply for the sponsorship, but actually at that time I even didn't think that I can get the sponsorship, because I know that my contribution to Debian is just very little. So at that time I just translated to news, and I was not confident that I can go to Germany for the DEFCON 15. Back from Germany to Vietnam, I still never imagined that I was there. And I got a lot of nice memories there. Though you didn't spend much time with me, but I spent my time to help the video team, to talk with other friends. And even it's like I told you that it's kind of magical that I got an adoptive father, but then I got more friends, and they are really nice and lovely people that even like last year that I met Jana from Germany and Lin from the United States. They came to Hoi An, and we saw each other again, not in Germany, but in Vietnam. That's awesome. And we had really nice time together. And in Heidelberg, that is kind of it's my very first time traveling abroad, and actually it's very new to me. That's so funny that that's the very first time that I saw the apple tree.
I think, the reason that you got the support is also that you are, well, from a country we don't have so many contributors, that we that you are women is also one point, and that you volunteer to the video team to do something. This is, we also pay attention to what we assumed you can do, and so you finally did it. So the decision to sponsor you was perfectly all right. So, well,
yeah, and even I got to know more about, like, I wrote you that I have no any IT background. I learned a little bit more, and I got help from some like developer. I remember that later I will tell you, but there are also some like contributor, Vietnamese contributor, that also helped me, and they are very patient, you know, because I don't know anything.
Yeah.
There's some like technical, I don't know, I don't understand, but
yeah,
they are so nice. Yeah.
I will tell the people here how you learned. It was actually, it impressed me from, always if I think on it, I'm really impressed, because first, Min enjoyed DevConf You see? And she also enjoyed the day trip. We were renting a bike there, and then we did some biking tour. And this is one of the moments that impressed me the most, because what you see here is the laptop I have given Min. This is the first time she is touching a Linux laptop at all. It's since 4 or 5 days, I don't know. And on the left is Philippe van der Wiel, and he is introducing Min into CVS, WML, and all the stuff she needs to understand to be a proper translator. It's about a 1 hour introduction. And I admit my brain would start to have boiling if somebody would approach me with all this stuff which I've never heard about it. And well, to say the truth, I was sitting here in front of this and said, no, this will not be good. But on the next day, Min was sitting next to me and started translating. So I was really, really impressed. This is how engaged she was and how she really managed. So, and after DevConf, we went to our home. And this is another moment I will never forget, because when we were sitting in the train from Heidelberg to my home, she said, well, my dad was not really happy that I'm going to Germany. And then I really started slowly thinking and said, well, we are some people from a Western country, have met a young Vietnamese woman for about 2 or 3 hours, and then we pay her whole flight for staying in Germany, organizing everything. And then this is some kind of a pattern which could really rock. And once I realized this, I said, well, okay, I'm now your dad in Germany, I will care for you, nothing will happen for you. And this, I really like this role to be her dad, so I never gave up it. I gave it up, so. And my wife also liked it a lot. We have invited her to our home, we have served her with some berry things she has never known before. We also try to introduce her into cheese, and but the cheese and wine party was probably the worst moment for me, because she can't eat cheese. And, well, anyway, we had some fun at home, right? Do you want to say something, Min, or should we continue?
Yeah, so by this chance, I want to say thank you again to Philip, the one who to know how to deal with the translation.
Yeah.
And he's really nice, but I don't know if he's still at DevConf 17.
Philip is not here at DevConf. I haven't seen him, but maybe he will come next year. And next year you also need to be at DevConf, right? It's a promise.
Yeah. And,
so, and then, okay.
And you know that, is it okay?
No, I would continue now with the next step in our partnership, because in 2016 we also went again to Vietnam, and this is Min's bar, Min's Vietnamese bar, and we are together rowing the boat, and I learned how to row, and with the help it worked. And yeah, well, but we have some tradition to do some umbrella photos. You know, this is at my place, and this is at her place. And Min is also dedicated to Debian, that she is doing photos in Italy. This was also, for her, it was the conference opened some kind of a door, because if you once have proven that you turn back to your country, then it's easier to get a visa. So she visited other friends in Italy, she also met like us, and so you see the umbrella in front of the Colosseum. And finally, 5 weeks ago, we went again to Vietnam to really fulfill what the role of parents to be at her marriage, at her wedding. And I need to admit, I was, well, at some point in time, playing this ma and bar role was a joke. But we took it really honest, and we were really, really invited as parents on her wedding. This was cool. You see the umbrella? To say the truth, it was hot. It was really hot. And after 30 minutes, I was totally wet. And then it doesn't become worse. It's okay. So we were really fulfilling the role as Ma and Ba, and I'm having a speech on stage, as it's only doing the parents. Her husband is translating me at this event. And, yeah, well, there are two marriages in Vienna. If you really like, I can do in the evening some report about this. Just ask me. And at this, at the other marriage, Min was translating. It was some kind of moving moment. We have no video recording because our camera said, oh no, it's too hot, I switch off. So, Min, do you want to say something? Do you want?
No, to just remind me a lot of all of them. This man with you.
Yeah. Maybe I continue just so I see you are moved. So these are the some kind of wedding images, and I need to say these two women, they do a coalition against me and make always fun of me. So I don't know if I like this, but yes. Okay, I like the two. And this is the other day, the official wedding where we all go to. This kind of photos is only for children and parents. So I can't say more. We are really her parents and really like this. And because I think a father should always give his son something valuable, I even gave my Debian knife. So this was hard for me. You know, there aren't any more. This doesn't exist. So, yes. And it was not really planned. It was kind of, yeah. Because her husband is also starting translating to Debian. Maybe we see them, the two, in Next Step Conf in Taiwan. Yeah, and at other DevCons, I'm known as a man with the plans at Debian Meet and so. And this DevConf, I'm known as a man with the photos, you know? And this is just because, Min can't come for personal reasons. And I need to say that the refunding was granted for her, also for this DevConf. So thanks to Debian again for confirming that she could come in principle. It's really great. And yes, for my wife spent too much time on the wedding, so she has not enough vacations, and so both are not here, but they are here with me in my heart and on the photos. Yes, and well, finally I'd like to say that Debian does not really simplify my work, but I love it, but it's really enriched my life. You see, my wife is very happy to traveling and so, and I found a daughter which was missing. I just have a son, and yeah, it's a typical way we say goodbye to each other on the airport, and I really hope to lift her up again soon, as soon as possible. Yeah, do we want to say some final words before we have some questions for the audience?
Yes. Thank you. Yes. I found my Mexican parents here. Thank you. And I have many more like good friends. And I want to tell everyone that you can find your family here, even your friend here. And really love. But I remember that Eric said that my world is better since you're in it. Yeah. That my world is much, much better than you are in it and that we are in it.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you as well. So, do you have any questions? You can answer together. Do you know some similar stories? Trying to adjust this anyway. So no questions. Everybody's happy. So As I said, if you are interested, I have also some pictures from the wedding. Also, 2 days ago, I did some report about Indochina. Who might have missed it? I can. Phil, there is a question.
Not really a question. I'd just really like to thank you for putting this together. It's brought back old memories, some quite sort of painful. and it's reminded me how much I was looking forward to meeting Min again. So hopefully you will come next year.
Yeah, I really hope that he will come next year. So, thank you for the comments. We have another comment.
Okay, this is a question for me. What have you done about working before meet Andreas and Vivian? What did you about work or studies?
If you understand the question.
I cannot hear clearly.
Yeah. What was your work before you met me? What's your profession?
I work as a translator.
Yeah. The translator in the city government of the city of Bern. Yeah. And she's seeking a new job now to move to Da Nang, to the next city. So if someone
I applied last week, but it seems that no one replied me.
I can't imagine. If I would be an employer, I would take you as an employee. So, more questions? So, otherwise we can stop now. And thanks a lot, Min. It was a pleasure to talk together with you. Next time I really like to be here on stage. It's easier to hug you with than in computers, so.
But I'm not confident to stand in front of a lot of people.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. So, that's all. I'm in.